able to. You know, back when we was coming up, as soon as you graduated, that was one thing you had to do is go register for the service. Mm-hmm. You know, when you got out of school, or when you got 18, I think, you got to register for the service. And Uncle Sam never did bother me, but, you know, wasn't nobody but me and Bobby. In my family, two boys. There were two boys and a girl. But anyway, we lived in Nashville. Me and Bobby lived in Nashville. Bobby got a letter from the Army. You know, they called him in to come in to join, to be in the Army, you know, go to the Army. Bobby didn't want to go to the Army, so what he did, he volunteered and went to the Air Force. He went to Lackland Air Force Base in Lackland, in Texas. Mm-hmm. And he went through the basic training, and then he had hurt his knee, daddy did a lot of logging, and he got his knee caught in between a log and on the truck, and they gave him a medical discharge because of his knee. Mm-hmm. Bobby got back to Nashville. A few months later, Uncle Sam sent him another letter, same thing, called him back to the Army. This is great. I don't see how they did that. He went right back to Lackland Air Force Base in the Air Force, same place he gave him a medical discharge. They accepted him, and he stayed in the Air Force till he got out. I don't know how they sent him right back to the same place, and then still already had given him a medical discharge, but when he went back, he was able to stay in the service. So that's how Bobby got in, but Uncle Sam never did bother me. I didn't have to go to service. Mm. And I always would like to see the world, but you know, it probably been a mistake of back then. All the black people going on the front line anyway and fighting war, you know, and getting killed and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. But that's the way it was.
Do you ever remember anything racist happening in y'all or us and our family other than Papa John being murdered and sharecropping and before that? But like,
Well, we, you know, I tell you, when we were down, when we looked at the other week, that, you know, we had a hard time going to school. You know, we got old enough, 6 years old, we had to walk 7 miles one way to school in the morning, 7 miles back. So we didn't have no school bus. I didn't have a school bus. And Daddy, I always had a truck as far as I could remember. So Daddy, I started going around in the country and picking up all the black kids in the country and put them on a truck and take them to school. And then he'd come back in the evening time and pick them up, pick us up, and distribute them all to their homes. He kept on doing that, and this guy worked tally. Mother used to wash and iron their clothes and go down the house clean for them. And worked tally, told Daddy he was going to see if he'd get him a school bus. So he met with the board of wherever they had to go, Nashville or Lewisburg. And anyway, they turned him down several times. But he kept on. Then they finally giving the okay for the blacks to get a school bus. But you know how we got our school bus? They had a school bus garage, a junkyard, with a whole bunch of old buses there. And they went out there and patched up one of them old buses, wherever it ran, and that was our bus. And a lot of more we wouldn't even make a school because school bus would break down on the road. Then you sit there all day before they come out and fix the bus. And then in the wintertime, you're sitting there, you freeze to death. And then it kept on, Daddy driving the bus. And then when the white bus drivers got the new buses, then Daddy got one of their best buses that they just got rid of, you know. And then that's how it kept on going. Then Daddy drove school bus for 30 years. And then before the school, well, quite a few years before the school was integrated. When school was integrated, they had all black kids and white kids, well, no problem. But that was a big racist thing for us, you know. We had to struggle. And 10 years ago, my first club, we always had a reunion over at Petersburg where we went to school every 2 years, you know, just the black people, a reunion. And Joe Kenner, he had said he was going to try to go up to Nashville and see if he could the state to issue a street name in Petersburg with daddy's name on it, because he was the one to cause the blacks to have a bus. And that's been about, I'd say, 8-10 years ago. He got it through, and they put the sign up. We were there when he put up the street sign from right there in Petersburg all the way down to the old schoolhouse. The old schoolhouse still standing where we started, the grade school, first grade. And they finally put the daddy's name up after he had been dead 20-something years before they could get that done. But I give my first cousin the credit for all that, because nobody else in there worked on it, you know. But anyway, that's what happened about that. And, you know, it was racist, but it wasn't really bad as Mississippi, Alabama, and all them places. But, cause, you know, we each went up the highway, and white folk usually throw your hand up, you know, still speak to you and everything, but still, there were a lot of racists there. It's just a terrible thing. But anyway, we were lucky to get an education. You know, with what we had to go through, you know, a lot of kids were dropped out of school and, you know, wouldn't got no education, but we kept on graduating from Petersburg to eighth grade. And then once you got out of eighth grade, we started high school. We went on to high school, and then when we got into high school, you know, dad had 2 cars, you know, we drive one car to school, one day we drive another car. The people there thought we were rich. But, you know, that way, made it good.